So Stewart, Mark Warburton has left the club. Since that time, can you talk us through the processes within the club?
Yeah, well, Mark obviously left on Friday evening. There's been a lot happening in the period since. You know, clearly we had a match to deal with, first of all, on Sunday. And I give my thanks to Graham Murphy and his team for you know, picking up the cudgel there and taking the team and doing a good job in a difficult circumstance at the weekend. I also like to thank the boys for the way they've responded and supported Graham and you know in that task and getting to, it was a big game to win on Sunday obviously because it's you know gets us through to the next round of the cup and hopefully got a wee run going there as well. We're now looking at you know the process of starting to look for the for Mark's replacement and we're also looking you know there's been chatting in the press about you know is the structure going to change and we are looking at changes to the structure and we've been looking at that for some time actually. But all this does is crystallise it really, you know, and we'll move apace with that, you know, going forward.
Very generally then, what is the plan? What happens next?
Well, we're continually looking at potential managers, you know, for the club. There's a, you know, a club of this size, it'd be foolish not to be looking at your succession planning as you would in any other business for your key positions. So, we've already got a database of potential names that we're aware of, you know, that we've done some diligence on already. We've been, inundated. It's fair to say with, quite a lot of people, submitting applications for the position. So we're sifting through those. We'll drop a short list. We'll then look at interviewing. I think it's important to say as well that we are also looking at that director of football role, and that's a key appointment for the structure of the club. You know, and this is a key plan. There's a very very clear plan in terms of how we're going to take this football club forward. You know, it needs to be a modern football club. You know, we're sitting here in the trophy room. We want the back of the days. So we're adding to the collection the trophies we've got here. So I think, from the supporters' perspective, they can take some comfort from the fact that actually, you know, that the plan is in place. You know, and that there might be, you know, the odd time you have to step back to achieve your plan. But we've got very clear goals of where we want this football club to get back to.
So at the moment, you've no specific time frame of when you would like a new manager to be appointed by.
I think it's more important we get the right person in for the job. You know, and I know again there's been some chat in the media about we have an interim manager or we have a permanent manager. You know, ideally you would get your permanent appointment in place from day one. It may be, you know, due to circumstances that's not possible, say for example until the summer, you know, in which case we may need to look at an interim, someone filling the role on an interim basis. However, it's our objective to try and get a permanent manager in place from day one.
What can you say about the job that in a very short space of time Graham Murphy has done so far?
I can only take my hat off to Graham so far. You know, he was thrown in at very short notice. He has risen to the challenge terrifically well. He's a very resolute individual. You know, he's in the few months he's been at the club, he's developed a very strong reputation for himself for the job that he's done in the under-20s. And we're delighted, you know, with what Graham's done so far. It's early days, you know, clearly, but he has worked hard. He's gained the respect of the boys, which I think is, you know, says everything. And again, you know, the support that he's had from the guys, I'd like to thank the guys for the support that they've given Graham so far.
What targets will any incoming manager, whether that be permanent or interim, have between now and the end of the season?
Well, for us, it's to finish as high as we can in the league, which realistically is going to be second place. You know, we need to try and get second place secured as soon as we can. There's a challenge there, but that's absolutely our aim. And the Scottish Cup, I mean, obviously we'd love to win the Scottish Cup this year as well, and that's a very, very clear goal that we've set for the team.
So what calibre of manager are you looking for to come in here at Rangers?
Well, we're looking for the highest calibre possible. Obviously, you know, a club of this standing deserves the highest quality of manager. We need someone who's got character, you know, someone who can work under the pressures of, you know, that he'll face in working at Rangers. You know, there's a lot of expectation at this club. There's a lot demanded of you as the manager of Rangers Football Club, and it needs a special kind of individual to work under those conditions. You'll get great support, you know, from the board, from the supporters. I mean, that goes without saying. The fans will get behind them, but we're looking for a top guy to allow us to achieve our plan, as I say, and to take the club right back to the top.
So looking at the next Rangers manager, what characteristics would you ideally like him to have?
I think we need a strong character, someone with a strong mentality, someone who understands and gets what Rangers is all about. You know, whoever comes in is going to get the backing, there'll be financial resources, but most of all we need someone who's a winner, you know, and someone who really gets what this is all about, and what Rangers is all about, which is winning.
The philosophy that's been instilled in the club over the last 18 months to 2 years, Why is that so important going forward?
I think it's something that there's no doubt people want to watch good football. I think we're football's you're in the entertainment business, and people are paying a lot of money to come and watch Rangers. Absolutely, they want to see the club winning, but if we can win with a bit of flair as well, then that's really what we'd like to do. We also want someone who's going to allow us to take on the good work that's been done in the academy. Craig Mulholland and his team have made great strides there over the last 2 years. And again, that's a key part of the club's plan going forward, is that you'll see some of the young players getting their opportunity in the first team. So ideally, we want a manager who's going to give the younger boys a chance in the first team. They have to be good enough, but there's no doubt we've got a great crop coming through, so 16, 17-year-olds. And I think the manager coming in will, there'll be a desire to work closely, a desire to bring someone in who'll work closely with the academy and bring these lads through.
You touched earlier on the potential appointment of a director of football. Why is that so important going forward?
Again, as a club, we want to be seen to be a modern football club. We see that sometimes when managers leave, a lot of the structure leaves with them. That's no use. You put a lot of time, a lot of investment, a lot of resource into actually developing that side of the business, and you can't have that changing every time a manager changes. The director of football gives you that continuity. They oversee the full, the overall football department, all aspects of it, the academy, the performance preparation, the analysis, everything, as well as the first team. And that then, it means if a manager or coach does leave, you're only replacing that one person. And the club's philosophy continues unbroken, if you have that director of football there.
Obviously, there's so many great figures been involved in the club of the past. There's people that you can be in contact with outside the club. Will the club seek advice from outside figures on both the director of football and the new manager?
Yeah, absolutely. We've already done that. There are a lot of good contacts, with the club that the club have. A lot of friends we've got in football, and it would be crazy not to seek that counsel and seek that advice from people with, who are steeped in the game, and have got a lot to offer us.
And on the academy as well, that you mentioned, just how much of a role do you feel they have going forward within the whole structure of the club?
It's fundamental to what we're doing as a football club. We invest a lot of money, a lot of time, a lot of resource in the academy. Craig Mulholland and his team have made great strides there over the course of the last 18 months in terms of modernising it, taking the club forward. You can see that with the representation in the international squads that we've now got, the 15, 16, 17-year-olds, the game programme they're looking to implement, it's our best of the best. And you can see the guys, the boys are growing through that. And it's a key part of the plan to get the club back to the top, is that we are growing our own. And I think the fans love it when you see young players coming through. I mean, I know I do. When you see a young player who's come through the academy and he's one of your own and he pulls on the first team jersey, it's a great thing to see and you hope they go on and develop.
And Rangers have a proud and rather unique tradition of having had so few managers in the club's long history. Is it unreasonable to expect longevity in any appointment going forward given the way football is these days?
I think it depends on the individual, and you just need to get that right fit. And there's no doubt the world has changed, from the way it was, say, 30, 40 years ago, when people tended to stay at one club for longer. You see it with players, as well as managers. But I think if we can get the right guy and give him the right conditions, the right working conditions and back him with the resources which will be there, there will be resources to back the manager coming in. And in terms of, strengthening the squad and, hopefully next year we'll have European football, we can then go on, we'll need to strengthen the squad for that. Then, hopefully we can have someone who's here for a few years. I mean, that would certainly be the preference, but you never know what's around the corner in life, as we've seen, recently.
And Stuart, just finally, what message would you like to give the Rangers supporters?
Well, it's very simple, Nick, and that is that, this board has a very, very clear plan about where this club is going. The last 2 years has been all about laying the foundations. We came into a situation where, where the club is broken, effectively. So there's been a hell of a lot of work done laying those foundations. There are resources in place to take the club forward. We want to take the club forward as quickly as we can. And, and contrary to what they may have read or heard recently, there is a very clear plan that the board are following and a very clear end goal in sight, which is to add to all the trophies and mementos that you can see sitting in this room in front of us. And it's getting Rangers right back to the top.